So I got this comment and I thought it was so big and there was so much to it that I would just make a video to respond to it. And it's from Tony, and he says, "You have to have money first to even consider buying a business. Not exactly a mind-blowing tip. One might even assume if you had enough money to buy a business, that would make you a millionaire. You are already on your way to becoming a millionaire. The easiest way to become a millionaire would have been for me to have mined cryptocurrency in its infancy, or get certified to sell commercial real estate and gotten into the stock market back when I turned 18. Most millionaires are in real estate." Okay, so this is not a dig on Tony at all. He's probably a great guy. So, Tony, if you watch this, you're awesome. Nothing against you at all. But there's so much in there that I kind of wanted to go through it. First, one might even assume if you had enough money to buy a business that would make you a millionaire. No, not even close. And that's followed up by that second point. You are already on your way to becoming a millionaire. No, not really. Most small business owners are not millionaires. So no. Now that might seem contrary to what I'm about to say, which is the most reliable, fastest way to become a millionaire would be by business ownership, because that's absolutely true. And what's great about that is both of those statements can be true at the same time. Most small business owners are not millionaires. Got it. However, the fastest, most proven way to get there is owning a business, which ties into the second point, so let's get to it. The easiest way to become a millionaire would have been for me to have mined cryptocurrency. Okay, so I'm in crypto. I have crypto. I have like seven different coins, variation coins. So love crypto. Yeah, that would have totally have helped. But even then, that would be a form of business ownership because you would have to take your product then to market and sell it, because there's a lot of cryptocurrencies out there that did not understand that they were still a business. And because of that, failed. So even then, business ownership. But let's keep going. Or get certified to sell commercial real estate and gotten into the stock market. Okay, I love real estate. I happen to own a real estate brokerage. So go real estate. And I've also owned millions of dollars of commercial real estate. Go commercial real estate. But nope, not true. Not true at all. Most millionaires are in real estate sales. Also not true. That one is not even close to being true. So let's cover this real estate idea, and then we'll circle back to the money idea. The most reliable way to create life-changing wealth, whether that's $1 million now or $100,000 50 years ago or whatever, has always been through business ownership. Real estate as a concept, as an idea of private ownership, in modern times, and I'm using modern with, air quotes and kind of a raised eyebrow, is only about 500 years old, really. Prior to that, people like you and I didn't own the land. If you were part of a people group that believed that nobody owned the land and Mother Nature was Earth, then nobody owned it. If you were part of a people group that had an emperor, a warlord, a shogun, whatever, well then royalty, nobility owned the land. And you and I still didn't own it. This idea of kind of private ownership for the masses is only about 500 years old. So in those 500 years, we can actually see a lot of proof in the pudding. According to Bigger Pockets, not me, not me. Again, I love real estate. Don't be writing down below, "Ah, you just don't like real estate." I own a real estate brokerage. Love real estate. But even according to Bigger Pockets, 95% of all real estate investments lose money. What? But they don't make it sound like that when you're watching those shows on Bravo, right? Make it seems like, oh man, everybody in this thing is just making bank. Yep, not true. Not true at all. Matter of fact, even when you look at the large amount of millionaires in real estate, and there are. There absolutely are. I don't know how many times I have to asterisk this. Love real estate. But there's just so many people in it, period, that you're going to have a natural skew anyway. What does that mean? Well, let's take his last comment and we'll go with that. Most millionaires are in real estate sales. First, it's not true. You actually have a higher likelihood of making $1 million in real estate ownership, more so than real estate sales, by far, by far. But even then, real estate ownership comes in number three or four. Business ownership way, way, way outshines. And then you look at that reverse skew, right? So in real estate, you have a massive amount of people in it, tens of millions of people. So if 1 million people become millionaires in real estate, everybody's like, oh, look, 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 look. And it even leads to these really bad articles like 90% of millionaires got there by real estate. Asterisk, asterisk, asterisk. And even if that's the case, which of course it's followed by a ton of asterisks, even if that's the case, they're not liquid millionaires. They're not the millionaires you think of when you think millionaire. Matter of fact, there's this common phrase in real estate, land rich, cash poor, because it takes a lot of real estate to generate what you would consider a millionaire lifestyle. But let's go back to the business owners. Now you take that same sort of proportionality to say, okay, how many people are in it and how many people are millionaires? And hands down favorite becomes business ownership. And then to make it even worse, you add to that real estate sales, and that's not even close either. Matter of fact, I just have the numbers right here. When it comes to real estate sales, unless you're part of EXP and Keller Williams, where they're telling you you're going to be a millionaire, woo! sorry. But the reality is that in cities like St. Louis or Houston or New York, you have more realtors than you do homes sold. And according to the National Association of Realtors, so not me, according to the National Association of Realtors, 87% of all realtors will be out. They'll fail. They won't make any money. 87%. And how many realtors are there? Over 2 million in any given year. So not 2 million, 2 million in any given year. So if you take 2 million, 75% of them don't even last a year. So now you're adding another million year two, another million year three, another million year four. The reality is that selling real estate is a terrible way to make $1 million. Absolutely terrible. Now, the last part of his message, or actually the first part of the message, but my last point, oh, you have to have money to consider buying a business. No, no. Matter of fact, it is easier to buy a $1 million business than it is a $1 million home. You will need less money up front to do it. You will need less of a good credit score. There are way better terms available to you. And if you bought a $1 million piece of real estate, depending on what it is, it might make you $10,000, $20,000, $50,000 a year. If you bought a $1 million business, that puppy might make you $200,000 to $300,000 a year. And of course, adjust the digits, right? I just picked $1 million to make a point and have easy math. But it's absolutely true. It is easier to buy, cheaper to buy, more profitable to buy businesses than real estate, which is why that's been around for well over 2,000 to 3,000 years. Hope that helps, Tony.